When I reached the age of five, I was due to go to school, which I did at the local school, which I have very fond memories. And there I met Miss Crawford, who was the headmistress. And we got on very well together, and it was discovered that I had a talent for drawing and painting. And this gave me a very easy passage through my primary school, because pictures are wanted desperately in primary schools, and most of their work is done with pictures, and I could paint these pictures. And I had been an assiduous reader. My sister was 2 years older than me, and she had learned to read. And so I learned to read from her simply by looking at the picture, and she would say what it represented, and I just had to remember what it was. And so I had that advantage also, that I could not only draw and paint, but I could read. So I was a star pupil and got on very well at school. Unfortunately, we moved from that location, and so, of course, I had to go to another school. But even so, there again, I shone with drawings and paintings and so forth, and it was a tremendous asset to me because I wasn't any good at anything else. I mean, geography and history and mathematics, they meant nothing to me. I couldn't understand, I didn't want to know about them. But I could write. I could write an essay with atrocious spelling, but however, the essays and the drawings and the paintings got me through my early school days. And after that, I changed school several times. They were all very undistinguished schools, and I didn't do anything to make them distinguished. Again, I could draw and paint, which was beneficial, and I had to do quite advanced stuff. And I learned the art of perspective drawing, and that was very useful and earned much praise, so that I wasn't too often chastised about the things I couldn't do.